All right, try that. Pause the video and try. So factor it out so that we can get common, greatest common factor out. So we have to pull out an a, and a to the fifth is the largest power we can pull out, right? So a to the fifth, and between the b, you have b to the, what, 3, 4, and 5. So that would have to be, what, 3? Okay, and so 5, a to the fifth, b to the third, and then write down the leftover. So 5 squared, so if we pull out 1, 5, there is still a 5 left, right? 5 times 5 is 5 squared. A to the fifth, so 2 more a's left because this is a to the 7, and b cubed, so the b cubed is all gone. From here, we are left with a 2, an a to the 1 power because 5 of them are out there and we had 6, and b cubed, so we need one more b. We have a negative 3, 5 is sitting out there, a to the fifth is sitting out there, and we have b to the fifth, which means that b to the third is out here, which means 2 more b's are left in here. Once you have that, now we can do for my is only column for the 5a squared times negative 3b squared, which is going to be negative 15a squared b squared. Once you have that two numbers, multiplying to give you negative 15, add to give you 2ab. So 5ab and 3ab, because the difference will give me 2. All right, so let's rewrite it. And now factor by grouping. So between the first two terms, we can pull out a 5 and an a, and then you'll have an a plus b left. So if I put a plus b here, so if I put a plus b here, then negative 3b times a will give me negative 3ab. Negative 3b times positive b is going to give me negative 3b squared. So now once we have that, we know it's 5a minus 3b times a plus b, and so that would be our final answer. If any of this is going too fast, don't forget, you can pause and rewind and go back. All right, so now let's try that. Hey, I haven't seen those in a while, so how can you do those? Remember, nothing new, it's fractions, so what's the first thing? Good, you want to get common denominator. So the first thing I would do is take these and factor them. So let's go for my is only column, and let's look at the first denominator. So we have 2x squared minus 5x plus 3, two numbers multiplying to give you 6, adding to give you negative 5. Good, 2 and 3. And they both have to be negative. That's the only way you're going to get a negative 5 and multiplication to be positive. All right, so then rewrite it and then factor by grouping. All right, so those are factors for the first denominator. Let's do the second denominator together. So multiplication is going to be what? Negative 12x squared. Two numbers multiplying to give you negative 12, adding to give you a 1x. So remember, all numbers multiplying to give you 12 are what? 1 and 12, 6 and 2, 4 and 3. Oh, 4 and 3 will work. So 4x minus 3x will give you a positive x. So let's rewrite it and then factor by grouping. Can you see how if I write x plus 2, negative 3 times x is negative 3x. Negative 3 times positive 2 is negative 6. So factors are going to be that. All right, so let's go back and rewrite our terms. All right, so now that we have the least common multiple, look at what we have here. We have 2x minus 3, x minus 1. So what factor are we missing here? We are missing what? X plus 2. So multiply numerator denominator of the first one by x plus 2. What is missing here? X minus 1 is missing here. So let's do that. All right, now that we have that, all right, so now we have to multiply all of these together and rewrite it. So do you remember how to get these terms over here? Distributive property of multiplication over addition. So x times x will give me x squared. X times 2 will give me the 2x. 1 times x will give me the 1x. 1 times 2 is going to give me the 2. So here we have x times x is x squared. X times negative 1 is negative x. Negative 1 times x is going to be negative x, negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. So now just add like terms in the brackets and then simplify. But you have to remember what when you simplify? That this negative sign belongs to all of these terms. Just don't forget that. So let's just take care of that first and see what happens then. So we're going to have x squared plus 2x plus x plus 2. And then this negative sign distributes all the way and giving you, remember how there's like an imaginary 1 there. Negative 1 times x squared is negative x squared. Negative 1 times negative x is positive x. Negative 1 times negative 1, x is positive x. Negative 1 times positive 1 is negative 1. Now add like terms. So x squared minus x squared, that's just gone at 0. Let's see what else we have. 2x plus x, 3x plus 4x plus 5x. So we have 5x and 2 minus 1, which is 1. So 5x plus 1. Again, x squared minus x squared, 0. 2 plus 1, 3x, 4x, 5x. And then 2 minus the 1, which is the plus 1. Try these on your own.